Wow, she had a real career, eh?
The film is fraught with issues, mm-hmm. such important issues, dating mm-hmm. back, you know, decades and mm-hmm. generations. Mm-hmm. There's a lot to take, there's a lot to digest, a lot
yeah.
for you as an actor, especially playing two roles,
yeah.
to wrap your head around.
Yeah.
So what, when you immersed yourself in it,
right?
You know, how tough was it?
Yeah, I mean, I felt immersed in some ways already. Just, I read the book when I was a teenager and it stuck with me and sat with me. And so when I found out that they were gonna make a film, it felt like all I had to do was just dive in. Like, you know, it was just such a beautiful and powerful and special experience. You know, I it was tough at times, certainly, but I also just felt like in wonder most of the time, like that this film was actually being made and I'm surrounded by this largely Indigenous cast, and how lucky am I,
yeah,
you know?
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Just having met you for this brief period of time, you are so unlike her. So
oh.
this is a real acting masterpiece, achievement.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
I mean, you related to her in those ways, but you gave her a physicalness and a way of speaking.
Right.
And all of that. So how did you work it?
Right. I mean, I know so many women who are hunters and are from the bush and
right.
kind of have that physicality and like that sort of resourcefulness and that strength. And so I just, I borrowed from them. Luckily, I've been surrounded by some really great, amazing women. And so, you know, I kind of took from pieces of that. And then, of course, she's from Musanee. So I listened to interviews and watched YouTube videos of people from Musanee so that I could kind of get the sort of that way of speaking right. And
yeah,
it was just a joy to do that, honestly. Like, that's what I, as an artist, that's sort of what I would love. I love kind of getting into. So it was, you know, it was like juicy. It's
wow.
fun. Yeah.
Absorbing, right?
Exactly.
And, you know, Annie's so driven. And,
right.
I mean, we all have that in us, but she takes it to another level because it's so important that she finds her family member, or at least clues.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, she's had to be really tough.
Yeah.
And create toughness.
Yeah.
So, I mean, when you were being really tough that way and
uh-huh.
leaving your friend in the middle of the night.
Right.
That's
yeah.
big deal.
Right. Yes. I think out of the necessity comes these different types of traits, like that she might come off as a bit reserved and be protective and a little bit untrusting of people.
A little bit.
Yeah, just a titch. Yeah. Annie? No.
But she's a warrior.
Right. And I think she's had to be, you know, and I see so many women in our community who have had to be, and you know, people like even my own mother included, who I look up to and see how she has been resilient and survived, you know. So
are you referring to the residential schools?
Yeah, residential schools, 60 Scoop, I mean, you name it. Yeah,
unreal. It's wonderful that we're getting so much Indigenous material in films these days.
Mm-hmm.
This year, last year, and the year before, there have been a lot more films made
mm-hmm.
on stories.
Right, yeah.
So that's very encouraging, right?
Yeah, it's heartening to see that there's more focus pulled to these special stories that wouldn't always, you know, get that kind of attention. So,
and
yeah.
people are really excited about them.
Yes.
Everyone wants to learn.
Right.
I think, and that's something like this helps.
Right, exactly. It makes it digestible, and then you're sort of able to walk through these character shoes and have empathy and compassion for them in a different way that yeah, I think is unique to film and getting to watch a film like this.
You grew up in a hunting community. Your family was hunters.
Right.
And So now you're traveling all over doing films and TV. I mean, wow. Yeah. I think there's a book there.
Right. Yeah, they're all pretty much like, they're all at the premiere last night and so excited and, you know, like, ooh, red carpet. And yeah, it's been special to get to share that with them. And yeah, I mean, being out here and being from like a little tiny village, it's super surreal. It's so surreal.
Do you get home much?
I get home, I try to get home like a couple times a year, but yeah. It's a trek.
Yeah, is it?
Yeah, it's a bit of, I mean, just, you have to fly into Vancouver and then there's a drive and yeah, so, yeah.
But you must miss it.
I do, I miss the mountains and and being able to be out in nature, you know, in a heartbeat, you know, that's really feels like home to me. So, yeah, I miss it. Yeah, yeah, concrete jungle. Yeah.